If you used to render interior scenes, you know what a portal is. If not, I recommend you to check it, as it is a very handful thing. You will be happy to hear that LuxCore can prepare portals automatically. This is called Environment Light Cache. Map width is responsible for resolution when samples define its number, which will be used to calculate the cache. Persistence is the same thing as in PhotonGI cache. It allows saving and loading the cache. There is also a direct light sampling cache that will help you to reduce noise when having multiple small light sources. You can set automatic entry radius manually, and it will be very similar to lookup radius in indirect light cache. So higher values for bigger scenes. Warm-up samples is the number of samples that will be calculated before creating the cache. Higher numbers are recommended if you will have problems with artifacts. In the Advanced tab, you can set normal angle that will treat two faces as one if angle between them is lower than specified. Convergence threshold determines when the cache will be ready. If for some reasons this threshold won't be achievable, max passes will limit the number of the entries. Using these settings, you will adjust speed and quality. Place entries in volumes is very self-explanatory. This option is by default unchecked, as you can produce a huge amount of unnecessary entries. I'm going to skip the light threshold, as it will probably disappear in the next release. The following three settings are used to create a list of the points that will define cache entries. In this process, paths are traced from the camera and create a cache entry on every bounce. Max depth will define how many times a path can bounce. No more samples will be processed than max samples, and work will be stopped when hitting targeted cache hit ratio. I'm not going very deep into advanced settings because it's strongly recommended to keep them as default. Persistence behaves the same way as in environment light cache. In the post-processing tab, we can specify if we want to use a compositor or sequencer. Column management is not LuxCore only feature, so we won't stop here for long. It is worth to mention to change view transportation from sRGB to filmic or filmic log to get wider dynamic range of the image. At the end, there are LuxCore tools. The first tool we can use is LuxCore Network Renderer. This is the subject for a separate tutorial. It is enough to say that you can use multiple PC to render the same scene. It can be done over the internet or local network. LuxCore FileSaver will allow you to export the LuxCore scene and use it outside the Blender. That's it. Render setting service is done. How did you like it? What I can improve? And what are the most interesting topics for you? Let me know in comments. Thanks for watching and see you soon.